so good of a week. Well, Monday was a pretty good day if you don't count the hamburger surprise at lunch or Margaret's mother coming to get her. Or when I got sent to the principal's office to explain that Margaret's hair was not my fault. And besides, she looks okay without it. Okay, fine. Monday was not so good of a day. Clementine by Sarah Pennypacker.
You can't touch my stuff.
Margaret's my best friend. She has rules. She makes me obey them because she's in fourth grade and I'm not. Why?
Because you can't touch my stuff.
And then I pointed out the window, which wasn't exactly lying because it didn't say that I saw something out there. While Margaret was looking out the window, I accidentally touched her craft. Okay, fine. Twice. Then I went back to gluing my own mask so I didn't have to hear any Clementine, you need to pay attention.
Clementine, you need to pay attention.
I was paying attention. I was paying attention to Margaret's empty seat. Margaret had been excused to go to the girls' room. And when she left, she had scrunched up, don't cry eyes and a pushed down, don't cry mouth. And she'd been gone a really long time, even for Margaret, who washes her fingers one at a time. I need to go to the girls' room. Margaret, you're sitting on the floor.
I am sitting on paper towels.
Still, what's the matter? On the sink, next to a pair of do-not-remove from the art room scissors, was a long chunk of brown hair. Oh no. Come out, let me see!
I'm not coming out until it's grown back.
Well, I think I see a germ crawling up your legs, so...
Ah! I got glue in my hair. I was just trying to cut it out.
Margaret's hair is halfway down her back long. It's hard not to notice the whole chunk over her left ear was missing. Maybe if we even up the chunk on the right side a little bit. It's like bangs. Sort of.
Except bangs are in the front of your head, not the sides.
Not so good. We looked at Margaret's not so good hair in the mirror for a long time. Then her bottom lip began to shiver, and she turned around and handed me the scissors. All of it?
All of it. Clementine, what are you doing?
And then Margaret went all historical, and the teacher went all historical, and no one could think of anything to do except the usual, which is to send me to the principal's office. But while I was in the principal's office, I colored a picture of Margaret with her chopped out hair. I made her look beautiful, like a dandelion. If theater class were gifted kids in art, I would definitely be in it. This year, I'm in a class for gifted kids in math, and here's a bad surprise. No gifts. I told Principal Rice about the problem when he got back from comforting Margaret's mother. So far, no gifts? He rolled his eyes to the ceiling like he was looking for ceiling things when he dropped down.
Clementine, you need to pay attention. We need to talk about Margaret's hair. What are you doing on the floor?
Oh, can you look for ceiling snakes?
What ceiling snakes?
See what I mean? Me paying attention. Everybody else not. The look they teach people to make in principal school, that's not very nice. I showed Margaret my drawing of her in the lobby of our apartment building.
I look like a dandelion.
Dandelions are beautiful.
For flowers, maybe, but not for people's heads. Besides, dandelions are yellow, not brown. Maybe that would help if my hair were yellow.
She took a long, I wish look at my hair.
Or red.
I'm sure I could do that for you, Margaret. Oh, sure, I can make your hair red just like mine.
How?
I got the box of special permanent markers where my mother hid them. Oh, hey Mom, everything went great at school. I was totally paying attention and now I'm going to Margaret's to play. I went back to Margaret in the elevator so she could look through the box.
Flaming sunset, perfect, let's go.
Is your mom still mad?
Yeah, but she took three aspirins and went back to work.
Okay, let's go. Ding. Ding, come on. Let's get on with the coloring. It is very hard to color hair with Margaret, let me tell you. But I did it. I colored every chunk of Margaret's hair flaming sunset, and then a brilliant idea popped into my head. So I colored flaming sunset curls all over her forehead, and on the back of her neck so her hair looked just like mine. All done!
Perfect.
I better not go to school today, Dad. I think I have cracked toes.
Nope.
That's not all. I also have the heartbreak of sore irises.
Nope.
Actually, I think I have arthritis. Mrs. Jacobin was breathing on me in the elevator, and I must have caught it.
Oh, please.
And this time he actually turned around.
Clementine, you cut off your hair. You cut off your beautiful hair. What were you thinking?
I just wanted to make Margaret feel better. I don't want her to be the only one. But I forgot, Margaret's going to the orthodontist to get braces on her teeth so she won't be at school. That day, I was back in the principal's office. Mr. Rice sealed his lips and opened the note from my teacher. I can't help it, I'm allergic to sitting still.
Nobody is allergic to sitting still, Clementine.
I am. My brother's allergic to peanuts. If he eats just one, he gets all itchy and he can't breathe right. If I sit still for too long, I get all itchy and I can't breathe right. I'm allergic to sitting still. So I wiggled on my chair a little to make sure I didn't have to go to the hospital with the ambulances and the sirens and everything.
Well, do you think you could wiggle a little quieter in class then?
I asked my body about this and it said, sure. So I told Principal Rice, sure.
All right, now as long as you're here, why don't we talk about your hair?
Thinking about my hair made me think about Margaret. Thinking about Margaret made me think about her getting bracelets on her teeth. Thinking about her getting braces on her teeth made me think about sharp things. So I looked out the window because the only way to erase sharp things is with rounding things, and clouds are great for that. Immediately I saw a cloud that would make a great tattoo. I'm not allowed to get tattoos yet, so I just colored stuff on my arm with marker. And then I noticed something very suspicious. I've never seen Principal Rice's arms. They're always covered up by principal sleeves.
Clementine.
Do you have a tattoo? Can I see it?
What? We were talking about your hair.
That was a long time ago. Then I added a warm smile because it's not his fault he can't pay attention. Thank you.